Welcome to Unlock Layouts. In today's topic, we are going to discuss how to generate the clone in the layout. Let's start the video. See, now we have this schematic. So in this schematic, so all the devices, so this is the AND gate circuit. So all the devices are identical devices. We have four devices here, all the devices are identical devices. So whatever the LNW value here we have, I have taken for A and B, same LNW value for A and B, and all the gate signal and output signal, net name, everything is same. So now here we are going to discuss how to generate the synchronous clone from the parent model. Just I am opening the layout from the corresponding schematic. So this is my layout. So this is my simple layout. This is DRC and LVS clean. So first inverter layout I have generated here. Okay, so this layout, routing, everything I have done manually, but in my schematic all the four circuits are same circuit, and as well as the layout also same, and as well as the LNW parameters also same. So each and every time, so we don't want to create a extra copy. For example, A, B, C, D, four devices are there, so we don't want to create one more time for B, C, D. So what we are going, right, we have a one more option in Excel, layout Excel, we have a cloning option. Just I am going to select all the devices. See, now my all the devices are selected. Here we have a third option called cloning. Just click cloning. After, once you selected cloning, you will get this pop-up window. So in this pop-up window, so the window will show you what devices you have chosen from the schematic. So M0, M1, M2, M3 is my schematic instance, the same instance I have placed in layout also. So this is my schematic instance name and as well as the corresponding layout instance name. So from where it has to take the source, we have a two options here. Either it has to take from the layout or either it has to take from the schematic. Now it has to take from the schematic, because in the schematic only I have three extra devices are there. And then what device it has to take? Only selected devices. Then allow the permutations and the exact parameter and exact connectivity. So always I have to choose exact connectivity, the same connectivity device it has to choose. And if you want the exact parameter, please click here, it will generate the exact parameter. So once you choose on the options from this cloning option, just click search option. So now here the clones are founded. So you will get a three clones are founded. See, I have M1, M2, M3 and as well as M0. So three devices is my main devices, and as well as I am getting the clone. So this is my first clone. See, just I'll minimize this and I'll go to the schematic. See, we have M7, M5, M4, M6. So go to this. See, already here it is highlighting. The second is highlighting. If I click the third one, see, the third ones are getting highlighted. Okay, so see, the devices, the third lines are highlighting. And then the last one, the third, the fourth, the last device is getting highlighted. So these are all my clone, but the parameters are same. Just again, we'll go to the layout. So this is my layout and this is my cloning window. See, I just click the first device and I am coming here and I am placing my first clone. The clone is placed. Again, one more. This is a manually, if you want to place single device, so you can select the individual device and you can place. If you want to place all the device at the single time, here you have option called select all. Click select all. Then first you have to place the third device, and second device also you have to place. So in this way you can generate the clone. So what is the advantage between the clone option? So what are all the advantage we have in clone option? First of all, whenever we are doing the multiple number of copies, right, we don't want to do the identical layouts in a same time, because again that will create a time waste. So we need to create a parent model. From the parent model we can generate clone. So in this way we can save time. And second, we can copy and paste the same thing. For example, if the four copy devices are there, just you can select all the devices. See, you can select and you can copy and you can place the same device. But here the problem is you don't get the Excel compatibility. So Excel compatibility means, for example, these four devices, right side we have four device, left side we have single device, but all the net names are same. So for example, if I want to connect this A, see, just I'm click path, see, if want to connect A, see, it is showing the net highlight option. See, wherever the net A has to connect, so we are getting the XL connectivity from the device to device. When we are generating the clone, in that time we will get XL connectivity. When we are copying and pasting the same device, we don't get the XL connectivity. So this is the way how to generate clone. This is just a normal way how to generate the clone. In the next video, we will discuss how to utilize the cloning option in matching patterns. Now we have two differential pair units. So this is a PMOS and this also PMOS. M0 is M1, both is the PMOS, and it is having totally 28 multipliers and two finger device. So now in this differential pair unit, I am going to do how to clone, or else how to use cloning option to complete the layout effectively with the fast manner. So I am just generating the all the layout from the schematic. So this is my layout window. So here I am generating all the instance from the my layout. So this is my generated layout from my schematic. So top side, all the devices are M1 devices. Bottom we have two pair devices. So these two devices are M0 devices. So we have only two devices in our schematic. So M0 and M1. See, just I am highlighting all the devices. See, right side. So bottom devices is my M0 device, and top devices is my M1 device. So both the devices I have generated, and I have merged the devices. So now I am going to do cloning. So what I am going to do first of all in this layout. So here I am taking simple matching pattern. Top side all the devices are A devices. So this is my first pattern, and this is bottom device. So bottom device also I am taking. So these two I am keeping right now. I am not doing anything here. Just I am taking only these two pairs. So just I am taking these two pairs and I am keeping in the top of my layout. So now we know the bottom devices, all the devices are M0, and top devices, all the devices are M1 devices. So now we know, right, in the schematic we can able to see. See, in the schematic the gate connection are different. So two different net, so bottom M0 is getting different gate, M0 is getting different gate, source is connected to power, and two different drains are there. So just now I am going to complete the routing. See, now I almost done the source and drain connection of the bottom devices and lower devices, which means M0 and M1. I have completed the source and drain and gate connection. Now I am going to generate the clone from this. So we'll keep it here. See, now bottom, this is not at all completed. Still the devices, source and drain, gate connection, nothing was completed. It was still empty. But this is our top pair. Source connection is already completed. See, source connection is already completed. Drain connection is already completed. And the gate connection is also already completed. Everything is done. So now this is my single pair. The top devices, all the devices are A devices. Bottom device, bottom all the devices are M0 devices. So this is my A device, this is my B device. So now first pair I have done with the matching. So whatever the matching pattern you are choosing, it depends on your wish. Now I am taking the top, all the devices are A, and bottom all the devices are B. And bottom we have one more pairs are there. This is still uncompleted, not even a single connection I have made here. So now I am going to generate the clone from the top one. First, what I said, we need to select all the devices. I have selected all the devices. Now I am going to the cloning option. Now I am going to the generate clone option. So in our cloning, so previously we have generated cloning devices from the schematic, but now we have already generated all the devices from the schematic. So devices are there. But what we have to do, right? Now we have to generate the cloning. Instead of schematic, now I am choosing layout. So then I am going to do the search option. See, again here I am getting one more clone option is found. Just click the one more clone option and come and place the same clone here. See, now bottom device, by default the bottom devices are getting disabled, and now we are getting the same routing clone. So whatever the routing we have done here, the same routing clone we have done here. So the cloning option will be very useful when we are using or when we are handling the more number of multiplier matching or more number of device patching. See, now almost one pattern I have completed, but after completion of one pattern, if the pattern was DRC clean, so now we need to work on the DRC rules also. If the parent block was completely DRC clean, so we can generate multiple numbers of clone with 100% DRC clean, and we don't want to waste our time to do the routing and to do the matching again and again. So this cloning option will be very useful when we are handling the more number of multiplier and more number of fingers. So this is the simple way I have generated the cloning. See, now if you want more also, we can upgrade the circuit by using clone. See, now what I am doing, just I am undo. See, now this is my undo status. So it was not completed. See, before I have told you how to generate the clone. So one more time I am going to explain how to generate the clone, because before previously we didn't add any guard ring here. So now even guard ring also we can generate by using clone. So what I am going to do right now, just I am selecting all the devices from the top device and then shift G for guard ring. See, now my device is PMOS device. I need to add NVL guard ring. So I have chosen the NVL guard ring and I click apply, then hide. So now the NVL guard ring is successfully placed in the top and bottom devices. So now including guard ring also we can generate the clone. So just again select all the devices including the ring, go to the clone option, select the clone option. Instead of schematic, now we need to generate all the things from layout, because previously in our previous video the devices was not instanced from the schematic. Okay, only one pair we have designed, from the one pair we have initiated the rest of the clones. Now in the differential pair unit we have already instanced all the devices are in our layout. Suppose if you click schematic and click for search option, so here you will get an error message, there is no target for the matching, there is no clone sources are available. Instead of source, if you click the layout option, click search, see now you are getting the clone option is available. See, now here the pink color highlight is getting highlighted by the clone option to the each and individual cells. See, now I selected the one more clone and I am placing the clone exactly here. See, now we have generated the clone successfully from the parent panel. So once you generated the clone option, still your clone option will be here. So this pop-up window you need to close. So instead of wasting your time to do the same routing pattern with the second pair, so this is the easy way to generate clone. So if you want, you can copy and paste the same thing, but you don't get the Excel compatibility. So for example, now suppose if I want to route the source to source, I am going here, just metal 2, I am taking the routing. See, wherever the metal 2 has to connect, so it is getting highlighted by default. So all the rose color lines has to be connected to metal ring. So by default we will get the Excel compatibility, and this is the easy way to complete the layout also in terms of when we have the tight schedule with the time. So cloning option will be very helpful to complete our layout in a proper way. I hope I have given some valuable information to you in this video. Thank you for watching my video. If you like this video, please click like button and share this video to your friends. For more details about this video, please contact us to my email ID and follow us on my Facebook page and Twitter page, and kindly subscribe our channel and don't forget to click the bell button.